This is a 3D image taken of a 17-year-old boy in which an exploding e-cigarette blew out several of his teeth and cracked open his jaw. Katie Russell, a pediatric trauma surgeon who treated the boy at the University of Utah Health Care and Primary Children's Hospital in Salt Lake City, Utah, reported the vape blew up his lower jaw, causing a major fracture and bone loss. Dr. Russell stated further, he also lost multiple teeth, had a large cut in his mouth, and some lip burns. Occurrences like these raise serious concerns in regards to the use of vaping devices. Recently, a Fort Worth 24-year-old Texas man was killed after an exploding vape pen severed an artery in his brain. A similar accident happened to a 38-year-old man in St. Petersburg, Florida. He died due to an explosion of his vape pen that sent two pieces of shrapnel into his cranium. The problem has to do with the highly volatile lithium-ion batteries used in these devices. The U.S. Fire Administration reported that between 2009 and 2016, at least 195 incidences could be traced to exploding vapes, of which 133 resulted in injuries. Healthcare professionals recommend refraining from the use of e-cigarettes. During the last several years, there has been a rapid increase in the teenage use of e-cigarettes. Researchers around the world are now scrambling to figure out what impact this new habit might have on developing bodies and brains. They're finding that e-cigarettes may be more dangerous than thought, especially for hearts, lungs, and brains. There's also a growing body of research suggesting that vaping can lead to smoking. Experts have identified smoking as one of the deadliest habits known to humankind. The use of e-cigarettes seems to be vying for a spot on the bad idea list. Several recent observational studies uncovered a link between regular vaping and an increased risk of heart attack, stroke, and coronary artery disease. Even when vapor is nicotine-free, it may carry heart health risk. The heating element in an e-cigarette can emit tiny particles, sometimes including metals, which can lodge themselves deep into the lungs and get absorbed into the body's circulatory system. This creates the potential for cardiovascular toxicity. Breathing vapor into one's lungs can irritate them. This has been shown in recent research on wheezing. Wheezing, that high-pitched sound, is caused by narrowed and abnormal airways and can be a sign of emphysema, heart failure, and lung cancer. E-cigarettes could potentially aggravate asthma, cause coughs, increase the risk for respiratory tract infections like colds, flu, and bronchitis. It's not yet clear whether young people are more likely to try cigarettes after vaping, or if vaping will lead young people along the path to becoming long-term smokers. The question remains, is vaping a good idea? For more information concerning addiction, visit us at the Institute for Addiction Study. Our link is in the description.